He did this to guide sentient beings to realize this very important understanding that pure wisdom is in all places and encompasses all things. It is part of nature, part of life and existence. The Buddha Dhamma is found within our own daily living. That's the life itself. It's Dhamma. It's our greatest teacher. If we don't have mindfulness, awareness, and the silent mind, we can never understand and comprehend this sentence, because you will never expect the Buddha to tell you that life itself is your greatest teacher. And the Buddha Dhamma is found only within our own daily living. It's not just go to retreat, go to the mountain, the cave, sit quietly in solitude. You can't find Dhamma there. Maybe in those places, the conditions are more conducive for you to silence your mind, to still your mind, to cultivate mental training, to stabilize your nature. But to understand truth, you have to come out into life. You have to go through life. You have to have relationship with all things. Man and nature must harmonize. You must come to the realization that all is one, one is all. We are not separated. So all this understanding is very important. So understanding the true meaning of suffering, you need to go through the teaching and you need to go through life. You need to expose yourself. That's why cultivation is not only alone. There are time to be alone. There are time to seclude yourself. But ultimately, you have to move out into life to really understand what humanity, human beings, living beings, and the environment are, what nature is. Then understand clearly, who are you, what are you? It's only within life that you can see the manifestation of truth. What is truth? Nature's law that governs life and existence. And they only exist within life, existence. That's why truth is everywhere. Why can't you see? For those who see, they always see.